Hello and welcome, guys, to the another episode of our discussion series. Today I have with us my dear friend Ruhan, who is going to share his experience on studying Masters of Food Science and Technology here in Australia. So let's welcome Ruhan and let's learn from his experiences. So Ruhan, thanks a lot for being with us today. So before going into the topic, would you like to introduce yourself to our viewers?
Yes, thank you so much, Vish, for calling me here. And like my name is Ruhan, and I finished my master's from RMIT in Melbourne, and I did my master's in food science and technology, and that's like 4 semester course, 2 years course. Yeah. I started in 2018, which I finished in 2020.
Yeah.
And that's really good course. And apart from this, they will help you to get an internship.
Yeah.
This will help you to get a job.
Yeah.
After internship.
Yeah.
And yeah, so it's a bit different from what we study in India and what we are studying here.
Yeah.
And I did my bachelor's in India in biotechnology.
Yeah.
So that was a bit related to that course. So that's why I chose food science and technology. Yeah.
So are you currently working?
Yes. Currently, I'm working in a pet food industry
as
a quality assurance or quality control officer.
Yeah.
And before that, I was in a different company that makes organic baby foods.
Yeah.
And I work like different sectors to get some experience in different products.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Yeah, that's good. So let's talk a little bit about your course.
Yep.
So when you applied from India, so can you please share us a little bit about what was the application procedure? What were the documents you needed while you applied for Masters of Food Science?
Yep.
And what was the English language requirement and what was the application and visa procedure? Can you please a little bit elaborate on that?
Sure, sure. So there are a number of consultancy in India. Like one of them is IDP. I came from IDP.
Yeah.
And they filed my visa, all my application files.
Yeah.
They just asked me my transcript from the last, like from bachelor's.
Yeah.
And they asked for the IELTS score, which is really compulsory, I think minimum 6 band or 6.5 bands.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's it. That's all what we need. And a good amount of money.
So let's talk about that tuition fee. So how much was the tuition fee?
Mine was like 18 grand per semester, like $18,000 per semester.
So it was like 18 by 4.
Yeah.
So almost like 70,000-80,000.
Yes. Yes.
And how about the living expenses?
Living expenses, like, depends, like, every person is different. Someone spent like 2 grand or 3 grand, and someone like 1,000.
Yeah.
So for me, it's like $1,500 per month.
Yeah.
Is enough. So every month you need at least $1,500 apart from your tuition fees.
Yeah.
So which is easily you can earn from part-time job.
Yeah.
That's not a big deal.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So you were internationally student, right?
Yeah.
So how long you could work every week as an internationally student?
We can work 40 hours fortnightly or 20 hours per week.
Yeah.
That's the legal, like, we can work only.
Yeah, and do you think like that will help?
Yeah, that's more than enough. If you're working 20 hours, that's more than enough. You'll get more than enough money for your living. So
And does that affect your study?
Actually, it's depend on the person to person. Like lots of my mates, they were like started doing part-time job and then they forget to study. They were like more into part-time job.
Yeah.
And nowadays, they just make their part-time job into a full-time job.
Yeah.
So I think we need to balance between what we want to do in our life. If you want to go, like we need to balance our part-time job and our career.
Yeah.
So
I think it's good if you focus more on study because that will help you get better job and your career will improve.
Yes.
The good thing with working is you will learn Australian experience as well.
Yes.
I think you need a good balance.
That's really like with my part-time job, I learned lots of things about Australian culture, which helped me in my, like after like getting a job, helped me in my job also.
Yeah.
But please don't involve that much in part-time job only.
Yeah, yeah. I think you always, as a student, you should always focus on
your that's study. The main motive why we came here. So,
And I also think like while you are studying, you should start developing networks as well.
Yes.
Right? Yep. Work might help, but it's better if you start developing networks so that will help you getting jobs.
Reference helps a lot in Australia.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if someone can refer you, that's the best thing. Like if you're in a company, you know there's a vacancy.
Yeah, yeah.
You just ask them, like, I have one of my friends.
Yeah, yeah.
He has the same background. Please hire him. So that's easy to get a job.
Yeah.
So networking, try to get and attend lots of seminars.
Yeah.
Like I got my first internship from a seminar.
Yeah.
Like I just attended lots of seminars and asked people to for an internship.
Yeah.
And once I get that internship, it was easy for me to get a job.
Yeah. So let's talk a little bit about your course.
Yep.
So what were the course you had to take in food science and technology? Can you please little bit?
So like we need to choose the subjects.
Yeah.
So there are different subjects like food micro.
Yeah.
Food micro, if you want to learn about food micro, food quality assurance,
yeah.
R&D research and development.
Yeah.
There was one new product development, similar
yeah.
to R&D kind of thing.
Yeah.
Food standards of Australia. And this in the last semester, it's totally depend on the person.
Yeah.
If he wants to go for like a company experience,
yeah.
we call it work experience,
yeah.
or if you want to go for the research.
Yeah.
Like some people wants to go for the PhD after master's.
Yeah.
So it's depend on you where you want to go.
Yeah.
And apart from this, you can learn the micro and the food composition
yeah.
and nutrition. The best
yeah.
part, like you get to know about the nutrition.
Yeah.
And yeah, this is what they taught us in RMIT.
Yeah.
yeah.
So also because you did your undergrad from India
yes.
and you did your master's in Australia.
Yes.
What do you think is the difference between Indian university and Australian university?
Oh, they are like, I think for me, it's a huge difference because in Australia, we don't have that much of exams. In India, we have lots of exams.
Yeah.
Here, we based on assignments. We do have exams, but not that much. Here it's more about like assignments,
yeah.
submit assignment properly, do some quiz, seminar,
yeah.
presentation,
yeah.
all these kind of things.
Yeah.
But in India, we have like lots of exams. People
yeah.
focus on exams
yeah.
and getting a good marks.
Yeah.
And here, no one asks me about my master's, how much I got
yeah.
in my master's.
Yeah.
They just really need your knowledge and experience.
Yeah.
So
it's
yeah.
more of a practical here.
Yes. More
yeah.
practical knowledge.
Yeah,
yeah.
They prepare you for a job.
Yes.
Yeah. But in India, I think they prepare you for an exam.
Yeah.
right.
Yeah, they prepare you for
yeah,
exam.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why you might struggle in job
yes.
after some time.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. So Sarwan, when did you say you graduated again?
2020.
So
yeah.
last year, right?
Yes.
So let's talk a little bit about job prospect of this food science and technology course.
Yeah.
So can you please share to our viewers how difficult it is to get a job with this degree, how easy it is, what is the job procedure, what is the job application procedure,
sure.
What are the platforms on which you can apply jobs?
Yeah, sure.
Can you please
yeah.
share?
So first of all, getting a good job, you need a good LinkedIn support. Like if you have a good LinkedIn members, you have got lots
yeah.
of people in LinkedIn,
yeah.
This will help you a lot.
Yeah.
If you ask lots of people, connect them and try to get a job,
yeah.
ask them. So what I used to do, I used to apply through Seek.
Yeah.
Like I apply any random job, XYZ
yeah.
number,
yeah.
like that's a company name. And then I go to that company's profile on
yeah.
LinkedIn
yeah.
and ask that particular guys
yeah.
about like how
yeah.
can I improve my application.
Yeah.
So that really helped me a lot to get
yeah.
a job.
Yeah.
So I finished my master's and after that I got a job
yeah.
over there only. Then
yeah.
after that I worked in a different industry.
Yeah.
So switching a job,
yeah.
it was easy for me because I like approach everyone
yeah.
through LinkedIn also,
yeah.
apart from applying to on Seek.
Yeah. So basically the most common platform is Seek and LinkedIn.
Seek, LinkedIn, yeah.
And
yeah.
you just don't apply. You approach the
approach
HR
company.
Professionals
yes.
from those companies.
Yeah,
right?
This will help everyone, like
yeah.
any profession, this will help you
yeah.
to like get a good connection.
Yeah.
And they will help let you know about like what's,
yeah.
what kind of person we are looking.
Yeah.
So I know like lots of times if you apply for the job, you
yeah.
know like that's
yeah.
suitable for you.
Yeah.
But might not suitable for the company.
Yeah.
So they will let you know about like
yeah.
what kind of person
yeah.
we are looking at right now.
And also that is good because you get chance to know the person as
yes.
well, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
And then HR also reminds you, oh, this guy did some extra efforts to get this job.
Yeah.
So he also feel like he or she feels like, yeah, he's a nice guy
yeah.
who really wants to work.
Yeah, yeah.
For the company.
He,
yeah.
Yeah.
So
let's talk a little bit about job types you can work with this degree. So what are the role you can work with this
yep.
food science and technology
so
degree?
Generally like people go for two things. One is R&D, second
yeah.
is quality department.
Yeah.
So and like third is raw material kind of things. Like that comes in quality department. So yeah, if you want to go into more innovation, like research and development things, then go for R&D. But getting a job in R&D after just finishing your master's, it's a bit hard, a bit difficult. I'm not saying like it's impossible. It's a bit difficult.
Yeah.
Because you don't have that much of experience.
Yeah.
But once you start your job as a quality, it's easy to get a job and opportunities are there. Lots of numbers
yeah.
opportunity for quality
yeah.
department. So once you start over there, then you might get a chance to
yeah.
move to food like department, R&D department.
Yeah.
yeah. So.
And also there are many food manufacturing industries, right? Food manufacturing and
lots
consumer
of,
goods, right?
Lots,
so
yeah.
you can get role in new product development department,
yes.
R&D department, quality department,
yes.
raw materials departments, right?
Yes.
So let's talk a little bit about salary
yep.
prospects.
Yep.
So with this food science and technology degree,
yep.
so how much on an average people will be able to earn after getting their degree?
Yep. So like I'll let you know about like me and my mate's experience when
yeah.
we started working in a quality
yeah.
department. The starting salary is around $60,000 plus super.
Yeah.
So, and yeah, that's the starting, and you can easily go around 80, 90.
And once you build experience and once you go into managerial role, you can grow on that as well.
Yeah. This is just a graduate level salary.
So, and you need more experience to get better in that, right?
Yes. Yeah, that's true.
So that's great, Ruhan. So we are slowly coming towards the end of today's video.
Yes.
So any final thoughts or any final suggestion you want to give to our viewers before I close, we close this video, to the viewers from India, Nepal, to the prospective international students?
Sure, sure. The only thing, like, what all the internationals, that's problem in that, like, getting a full-time job.
Yeah.
They all just convert their part-time job into full-time because they just focus on money that time.
Yeah.
So don't, like, focus on study also. Yeah. Don't convert a part-time into full-time after finishing your studies.
Yeah.
So try to get some experience
and
connect lots of people and try to get some, go to different seminars and try to get, like, ask people to connect on LinkedIn and try that thing. It might help you. Yeah. And apart from this, if you want to get a PR in like food technologies field in Australia, and if you want to settle down here, so try to work in a countryside.
Yeah.
There are lots of food companies which are in countrysides, like regional area.
Yeah.
So if you work there, you will get some extra points.
Yeah.
And this will help you to settle down in Australia.
Yeah.
And apart from this, if you need any help regarding PR, just ask Pish or this channel. Comment section. Just write down comment and this video.
Yeah.
We'll let you know about that. How can we help you to get PR here in Australia?
Yeah, also. Yeah. So this course is good if you want to get permanent residency as well.
In Australia, rules change every month.
Yeah, every month. Yeah.
So right now it's good. Yeah. To work as a food technologist and getting a PR, it's not that hard, I'd say.
Yeah.
But it's still hard. If you're a nurse, then it's very easy.
Yeah.
But if you're a food technologist, it's a bit hard, but not it's not impossible. It's possible.
Yeah, that's good. Thanks a lot, Ruhan, for sharing your experiences. It really means a lot to my channel. I really appreciate it. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching our video. I hope you liked our content, and if you like our contents and our videos, please do not forget to leave your comments down below in the comment section. And also, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel. That will motivate me to make more contents like this. I'll see you again in next video. Until then, bye. Thank you.